Hi, I'm Kris Hammond. I'm a professor of computer science at Northwestern, and I run our master's program in artificial intelligence. And as I talk to people around the world, I'm stunned when people say, I asked ChatGPT how Bitcoin was going to do, as though these systems in general have some access to truth. The reality, though, is that for any given language model, you can get it to say really almost anything. And to show you this, I thought, why not have a debate? So what you're going to see now is two different avatars, one model told to think one way, and the same model told to think another way. And so I'll give you Elizabeth and our kiosk, giving you a debate on what's going to happen with AI.
AI augments human capabilities by automating mundane tasks and unleashing creativity.
We can already see it coming. AI threatens jobs, displacing workers and deepening economic inequality.
Embracing AI empowers society, fuels economic growth, and enhances our quality of life.
Over-reliance on AI undermines essential human skills and poses unprecedented security and privacy dangers.
And of course, people have been talking about what AI has to say about Bitcoin. And so let's take a look at a Bitcoin debate.
Bitcoin's scarcity and network effects will drive its price higher.
Over the next 2 years, Bitcoin will face downward pressure as geopolitical tensions undermine market confidence.
With a fixed supply of 21 million coins, ongoing halvings ensure Bitcoin's long-term scarcity remains intact.
However, strong dollar rhetoric and hawkish fiscal moves could blunt Bitcoin's appeal as a safe haven.
Of course, these systems are designed to be polite. But with a tiny little tweak, you can have them not only not be civil, but actually be kind of rude and brutal with each other. And so the same Bitcoin debate, but with a little bit of ugliness to it.
Honestly, anyone who thinks Bitcoin is going to tank clearly doesn't understand basic economics.
Only a fool would ignore the regulatory landmines and economic stupidity ahead of us.
Corporate treasuries aren't brain dead like you. They know a real hedge when they see one.
Your naive hope that no hacks will happen is the epitome of clueless optimism.
These models, these systems, aren't standalone. They exist because they learn from us, and whenever we use them, we train them to do things the way we want them to do. And so what you've seen is, again, one model taught to think one way or another way, taught to have one set of opinions or another set of opinions. And it's always important to understand that the human is the driver, not the machine.